Hello, Bookishrans. Welcome to my March wrap-up part 3. In this video, I will first of all talk about the bookish statistics for the month of March. In the second part of the video, I will talk about how I did on my weekly reading challenges. And I will conclude the video with the books that I've read for the readathons that are participated in March, which were March Mystery Madness, Middle Grade March, and Fierce Reads Readathon. In the month of March, I read a total number of 15 books. I read 5 mystery, 3 general fiction, 3 thriller, 2 fantasy, 1 romance, and 1 comedy. I read a total number of 4,166 pages. I read 2 works less than 100 pages, 3 books between 100 and 200 pages, 2 books between 200 and 300 pages, 6 books between 300 and 400 pages, 1 book between 400 and 500 pages, and 1 book between 500 and 600 pages. My average page number per book amounted to 277.73 pages. I read 1 book published in 1600s, 2 books published in 1930s, 1 book published in 1940s, 1 book published in 1950s, 1 book published in 1970s, 1 book published in 1990s, 1 book published between the years 2000 and 2009, 3 books published in 2010s, 3 books published between the years 2020 and 2023, and 1 book published in 2024. I read 9 works originally written in English, 3 books originally written in Turkish, and 3 books originally written in French. I read 3 translated works. They were all works originally written in French, and I read 1 French book in its English edition and the other 2 French books in their Turkish editions. I read 12 books targeted towards adults, 3 books targeted towards middle grade audience. I read 12 novels, 1 novella collection, 1 poetry collection, and 1 play. I listened to 7 audiobooks, read 5 ebooks, and 3 paperbacks. I read 5 books taking place in the United States of America, 2 books taking place in Turkey, 2 books taking place in France, 1 book taking place in England, 1 book taking place in Ireland, 1 book taking place in Germany and Turkey, 1 book taking place in England and Greece, 1 book taking place in USA and Italy, and 1 book taking place in a fictional country. As for my ratings, I rated 7 books 7 out of 10, 4 books 8 out of 10, and 3 books 9 out of 10. My average rating was 7.64 out of 10, which is the highest rated month since I started taking my bookish statistics. So it was a great month in terms of reading. For Reading Around the World Challenge, I read books taking place in 8 different countries. Those countries were United States of America, Turkey, France, England, Ireland, Germany, Greece, and Italy. In the year 2024, I have read books taking place in 15 different countries so far. And 4 of those countries were the new countries in the map. This month, I added Italy to the map, and the total number of countries in the map is now 41. For Read Your Shelf Challenge, the prompt was to read a book with more than 2 points of view, and I read The Guest List by Lucy Foley. I think there were 7 points of view, including the narrator. So this was one of the most suitable books for this prompt. Like I said in the beginning of the video, I participated in 3 readathons. The first readathon was March Mystery Madness. In my TBR video, I mentioned that I would not do the prompts with the exception of one, which was the prompt for Janelle, a book that reminds me of Janelle, and which author can suit better than Agatha Christie for remembering Janelle. So I read The Hollow by Agatha Christie for the prompt of Janelle. And I read a quite number of books, even though they were not for any of the prompts, which were The Secret of Shadow Ranch by Caroline Keane, Kayıp Tanrılar Ülkesi by Ahmet Ümit, The Secret of Redgate Farm by Caroline Keane, The Guest List by Lucy Foley, Vertigo by Pierre Beloe and Thomas Nagerac, Verity by Colin Hoover, and I Know My Name by C.J. Cook. For middle grade March, like March Mystery Madness, I've decided not to do any of the prompts this year. And for this readathon, I read three middle grade books, which were The Secret of Shadow Ranch by Caroline Keane, Bridge to Terabithia by Catherine Patterson, and The Secret of Redgate Farm by Caroline Keane. The new readathon that I participated was Pierce's readathon. And for this readathon, I actually decided to do the prompts, and I read a book for all the prompts with the exception of one. For the prompt of picking a book by a fierce female author, I read The Hollow by Agatha Christie. I mean, who can be fiercer than Agatha Christie? For the prompt of choosing a book with a strong female protagonist, I read The Secret of Shadow Ranch by Caroline Keane. Nancy Drew is quite a strong character, for sure. For the prompt of highlighting your favorite characters from the readathon, I will choose Leslie Burke from The Bridge to Terabithia. This girl, who's 10 years old, has a very strong personality. She knows what she wants and what she wants to be. And she's not afraid to be different from the other children. But she is also a very vulnerable character who desperately needs a friend like herself. And with her friendship and loyalty, Jess, who's the other main character, chooses not to hide his true passion, which is arts and crafts. And he owes all of this to Leslie. The next prompt was to discover a book by an up-and-coming female author. For this one, I will choose my dear friend, Leyla Önkan Kurt. She very recently published her first poetry collection, and I'm hoping that she will have more many to come. For the prompt of reading a book that explores the bonds of female friendship, I read The Secret Life of a Vampire by Carolyn Sparks. The friendship between our heroine and her roommate was one of the most significant relationships in the book. I think up until this book, this was the best female friendship in the whole series. For the prompt of reading a book based on a female mythical character, I did not read any book. Since the host of the readathon stated that any book written by a female author would count, I also read Büyük Defter Kanıt, Üçüncü Yalan by Agatha Christie, Verity by Colin Hoover, The Secret of Redgate Farm by Caroline Keane, The Guest List by Lucy Foley, and I Know My Name by C.J. Cook. This was my summary of my reading in the month of March. Quite a social month for me. Please comment down below, what was your favorite book that you read in the month of March? Mine was Under the Whispering Door by T.J. Clune. And if you're a new viewer, first of all, welcome. Please like and subscribe. Hope to see you very soon. Bye! As for Turkish word of the day, I'm going to choose name. Name means isim in Turkish, and isim is our Turkish word of the day. Have a good day!